Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, with another in the series on the 1857 phone autograph. Well, today is the day. We are going to do our first recording. So I've just smoked a new piece of paper, and I accidentally touched it there. But oh well, good enough for the first test. So, sorry. Been breathing a lot of carbon. Even through that mask, it seems to get everywhere. In any case, I'm going to do the first recording on the phone autograph and see if we can genuinely make a phone autogram. So I've just reinstalled the mandrel on the machine. I'm going to slowly adjust the stylus. So I'm trying to get this just as light as possible, but still leave a nice clean line. So these are going to be my control grooves. Those are unmodulated, as you see. And that looks like it's going all the way around without any problem. Bring it down a little bit heavier. All right, so now instead of using a tone, I'm just going to speak into the horn as if I was using a tin foil phonograph. Now we have unmodulated grooves here, so we should see a distinct difference. Now I have to see if the stylus is going to begin to bounce when I start speaking. So I've adjusted the stylus probably deeper than it needs to be or heavier than it needs to be. But it's making one nice continuous line. So this is the grand experiment. We're actually going to see if we can make a sound recording on the 1857 phone autograph. So we have our control grooves. So just like a tinfoil phonograph, I'm going to recite Mary Had a Little Lamb while I turn the mandrel. So I'm going to be speaking directly into the back of the machine and cranking this with my right hand.
Hello, hello, hello. Mary had a little lamb. Its fleece was white as snow. And everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go. Ha, ha, ha.
So it looks to me we have modulation. We have a working phone autograph. So, well, this was an interesting experience, no doubt. So now that I know the machine actually works and records sound, and we can see the modulation quite distinctly, nothing like an original full-size phone autograph, but this is a really small machine with really, really, really small grooves. But even so, as you see, there is no doubt this machine is recording sound. So now it's the continuing experiment to make it as efficient as it possibly can be. We've got really decent modulation considering I was just talking into the back of this machine. So now I can begin to experiment with placement of the stylus. The adjustments on the phonautograph are really, really quite difficult to do. And the reason for that is the sound box and horn is mounted on an adjustable slide mount. And you can raise it and lower it at the back, which really changes the angle of the stylus at the front. So now I've got to figure out what is the best adjustments for the machine to get the best recording that it can make. But as I said, obviously there is no doubt at all we have modulation in these grooves. So we have a working phone autograph. And we've just made a phone autogram. That is really, really cool. So I just wanted to do a video to document it. This is the very first recording on black and paper. This is as close to the original as I could possibly get, even down to pure carbon on the paper. And the machine is recording sound, as you see. That is really, really cool. So as always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.